Good morning, folks. This is Bofa, yet another super typhoon in the West Pacific. It has weakened significantly now, but the rain, wind, and damage to infrastructure is mounting. At least two are dead, and as night falls in the Philippines, we'll have to wait till tomorrow for more. This is for my electric universe proponents out there, who can read between the lines. Had more quakes way down south, east of Australia. Meanwhile, up in southern Alaska, an earthquake rattled near 6.0. Again, way up north, quaking, making a comeback last few days. An unusual tremor in the Eritrea area near the Gulf of Yemen, and a 5.5 just off the subduction zone here. Still have that low parked over Europe, bringing dry and moist together. Most of Europe should expect precipitation. The southern edge of the red high pressure is guiding cold air to Tasmania, while the backside is under thunderstorm watch, along with about half of New Zealand. The US continues to break daily heat records. These lows in the north are churning up the southern air further north than usual. Where that northern air rushes down the caboose and meets the moisture coming north, we get that exploding cloud cover in precipitation. This is another low that was pinched off that northeast Pacific low. You guys got a little break last 2 days, but more is certainly on the way. Raining in waves across Canada, out in the Pacific, tomorrow's weather waits. Major cool down of flares since last week. Heliocentric alignments today and tomorrow might change that. The solar wind speed and density, the yellow and the orange, are both on the rise, but our shields are handling it very well. We did get that calm solar day we were expecting. Couple things to watch for, but shouldn't be geo-effective space weather today. Eyes open. No fear, it's 6:15 a.m. Eastern time, and that's the news. Be safe, everyone.